Hey, how are you?
Fine, nice to see you.
Good
to see you too.
Seabreeze salutes the Spirit of Young America Award winners. I'm very honored to present you and your husband with this award, the Spirit of America Award. And we're very honored to be in your presence today. And your determination, dedication, leadership, and courage have been an inspiration to us all.
Oh,
Thank you.
Now, I'm not incorrect. I think they want pictures of that, right? I'll find a place.
Do they have something else for you?
She'll take that one. We have another thing here. This is a postcard signed by the 11 representatives of the 50 winners.
Oh, nice.
Just to wish a happy birthday to your husband.
Thank you. I'll tell him.
Okay.
I'll give him 11 kisses. Thank you very much. Very much. And my husband, thank you, also. And I really, all that you've said to me, I can say right back to you, because I'm so proud of you and all that you've done, and all the courage that you've shown, and the compassion that you've shown, and the integrity that you've shown, and the hard work that you're doing for the drug program. And I'm very, very proud of you. Very, very happy to have you here.
How's the pregnant feeling?
Pardon me?
How's the pregnant feeling?
Feels fine.
You
all recovered?
He's all
recovered.
I'm going to be
76
tomorrow.
Isn't that great?
What are you planning for?
We're going to have two couples in for dinner.
What are you giving me?
Secret.
A big birthday cake.
Of course.
Is your husband feeling well enough to do a whole press conference? Talk to us. We haven't seen him in quite a while.
Well, you've seen him.
We've seen him. We've not had an opportunity to talk to him in quite a while.
Well, he has been recuperating, you know.
Yeah.
I to answer your question, I don't know anything about a press conference.
I'm just curious if in terms of his recuperation and his recovery, whether or not it's gotten back to a point where he can resume the kind of contact with the press, even in photo opportunities, that sort of thing, that he hasn't been doing in the last few years.
Didn't I see some photo opportunities the other day in the paper?
We heard you were behind it.
That I was excluding the reporters?
No. You wouldn't do that.
You know that's not so.
Who is holding him back then? Is it the doctors? Is it Mr. Regan? Who might it be?
Well, I don't know that anybody is holding him back. There was a recuperative period that he went through. Everybody has to go through. As a matter of fact, there are people here who have gone through the same thing. And they went back too soon and got into difficulty.
We had the feeling, though, that he should have deliberately shielded from the reporters.
Well, that's incorrect.
Does he not want to talk to us?
Oh, he's dying to talk. Every morning he wakes up and he says, I'm just dying to talk. And the last thing before he goes to bed tonight.
You know, Reagan, you mentioned a few weeks ago that, in fact, there had to be a period where the president withheld his comments on the Iran-Contra affair until certain things came out. One of those that you mentioned was the Senate Intelligence Committee report. That's now out. In terms of what you were saying before, is the way now clear for him to comment on?
see, I'm really not, I'm honestly not the person you should talk to about this. It's my understanding the Senate Senate report isn't completely out. Is that incorrect?
Well, the Intelligence Committee report is out. Of course, the other committee goes off.
Yeah. And the Tower Commission will be out on the, what, 17th?
19th.
That's all I know. I don't really know anything about
what... Well, I'm just curious if he was waiting until, say, the Tower Commission or some specific point in time.
Well, I think he would, as I said before, that he would rather that all of this get out before he makes any kind of comments, that he thinks that's the most responsible thing to do.
Do you think he's over the hump now in terms of the main part of all the story breaking and scandal?
But what do you think, Helen?
Well, I think that he seems to be into neutral now.
Into neutral. Well, then that's over the hump.
Well, you don't know what's ahead.
No, you don't. Which is a good reason for him not to,
Does he think he's weathered the storm? The peaks and valleys that you spoke of.
The peaks and valleys, yes. Yeah, peaks and valleys in all of our lives. He's just waiting for everything to come out. He wishes everything would come out.
Tell us this, Mr. Gray, if you would, as he approaches the 76th, last month, of course, there were a lot of stories that hinted that he might have lost a step, that he might be slipping as he ages. How did you feel about those stories at the time? Do you think they've been put behind him now?
I felt they were ridiculous. And anybody who's been in some meetings with him lately would tell you the same thing.
Mrs. Reagan, there's been a lot of staff changes on his staff at the White House. How does he view those? Is he concerned about...
Well, Mr. Casey was ill. And Mr. Carlucci was there because of what happened. So you can't, I mean, I think people have said there have been a lot of staff changes and they've not taken into account that one man was sick. One man was let go, and Larry had this great offer.
But still, it didn't sort of gap, doesn't that?
Another
worry about moving ahead.
No, it doesn't even gap because it's been filled in. Frank Carlucci is there. Gates is there. Somebody will be there. Larry's place has been filled. I mean, there are no gaps.
What about Don Regan? Do you expect him to stay on, Mrs. Regan?
Come on.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Has he shared all those notes with you or any of those notes that he takes?
No.
I thought about what happened today?
No.
Thank you very much.
Do you keep a diary?
Pardon me?
Do you keep a diary, daily diary,
yourself? Sometimes.
Thank you. May we call lights, please?
Thank you very much. I should have left and had you all question them.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Poor things, you were wondering why they were going to come, weren't you?
They got it before
you
came in.
Goodbye. Thank you very much.
Thank you
very much.
I'll
be going traveling tomorrow.
Pardon me?
California?
No, Monday. I'm going to Florida for the drug program. No, tomorrow we celebrate his birthday.
Right.
Because we won't see him. Wish him a happy birthday.
Gee, I'm glad you miss him so.
How many candles?
I think two or three.
Are you going to look at that house again out in California?
No, I'm going to look at a couple of others.
You're looking at a couple of others?
Oh, sure. There's nothing.
You don't like that one they bought for you?
No, I like it. I like it. And they didn't buy it for us. I like it. And we may, that may not be it, but on the other hand, may not. I'm still looking. Thank you again.
Thank you very much.
Bye.
everybody.